Hey guys, welcome back to World of Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, if you have a BMW such as X4 or Z4, guys, with the 4-cylinder gasoline engine, also known as N20 or N26 engine, guys, stay with us and we'll show you guys flywheel, holder tool, how to use it, guys, what it looks like, and you will need that too, guys, if you're doing the timing on your engine, if you need to remove and replace the crankshaft bolt or anything like that, because otherwise, guys, you're going to break your block and you may end up needing new engine. So you definitely, guys, need that too if you need to work on your timing chain. This is a weak spot on that engine. The same engine has been used in these 5 series, guys. And quick introduction, every single car we get at the shop, including this one here, we make at least 200 to 300 videos, guys. Why? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. Now, if you guys need to see where we bought the tool from, we'll have the link in the description of the video below for your convenience, so please check it out, guys. What we're doing here, that same N20 or N26 engine, guys. Both of them share the same tools. Pretty much it's the same design. We're doing, guys, timing chain replacement. The timing chain failed on that engine. Timing chain guide pieces are in the oil pan. Let me show you guys right there. Those are the pieces of the timing chain. And if you have one, this one has only 87,000 miles. Certain years are affected, guys. If you want to see the whole video, how to remove and replace timing chain on that engine, everything from start to finish, guys, very detailed and long video, we have that on our main YouTube channel, Auto Repair. Guys, check it out, guys. The whole video will be there from start to finish. So now we'll go ahead and show you, okay, what we need to do actually, okay, to use that too. Okay, let me get my tissue here for my pocket. I guess I don't need to share that with you. So this is the tool, guys. You want to get the one that has that design with the two bolts. I'm going to talk about that more in a little bit. Why? Simply, guys, because if you get the one with the single bolt, what could happen, guys? Okay, they snap. From what I read, that they're not very reliable. The two bolt design is more reliable. We have the link in the description of the video below, guys. If you try to get that bolt loose now, it's not going to work, guys. Okay, on the crankshaft, because if you're just relying on your little bitty pin that's for the TDC point, okay, you're guys going to break your engine block. You don't want that to happen. So bear with me now, guys. I'm going to go underneath the car now and show you, okay, what to do. So I'm going underneath now, guys. Okay, it's very, very limited room, so we're doing our best, guys, to show you everything we can. Okay, and just coming this way now. Okay, let me focus a little bit so I can show you with greater detail where things are and what we are going to do. Okay, perfect. Now, this is where the timing pin is located for the TDC point. Now, this is the very bottom of the transmission. We're going to pull that thing out. Okay, like that. You're going to get your tool loose to where, guys, okay, that tool can slide back and forth. Okay, check it out how it can slide in the bolts, right? Okay, you can see that. Now, you want, guys, those teeth, when the engine is at TDC point, only TDC point, we have the video on the channel that explains how to bring it to TDC point. You want to get it in the flywheel. Okay, get it in the flywheel, stretch it all the way back, and okay, the moment you stretch it all the way back, okay, what you need to do, just get the two bolts tight. Now get them tight, not by hand, use the wrench, guys. Okay, I'm using by hand only because I'm just laying with one hand under the car. But that's how you guys, okay, install the flywheel holder to you guys. Okay, and that's we'll be ready for removing the flywheel bolt now. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you having a Z4 or X4 with that 2.0 engine. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.